goes down and the lights go up, come sail with us.
Welcome to the party lounge, ladies.
It's the lounge right on wheels.
Complete with your own cocktail waitress. Let us do the driving, you do the partying. Try your hand at our slot machine and walk away with cool prizes. Everyone's a winner. Who knows, you may end up in our picture gallery. Don't worry, what happens here stays here. The Party Lounge. Call and book your next party with us.
From Mars, women are from Venus. Hey, we're just trying to put the two planets into one orbit. People, work with me. Today, Venus says, I just can't trust him. My first couple has really put that to the test in their marriage. Mikki says her husband of 3 years has too many lady friends. Mm-hmm, Mikki, why do you say that?
Because he does.
How'd you find out?
Well, usually we meet them together or they're mutual friends or whatnot, but he's the one calling them for things. They're calling him for things. I never talk to these women on the phone, you know?
Well, was that the way it was before? You were married, right?
We're still married.
You're still married?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay, let's find out what Mikki's husband, Mark, has to say about all his lady friends. We're going to find some more info after this.
When the sun goes down and the lights go up, come sail with us.
Welcome to the party lounge, ladies.
It's the lounge right on wheels.
Complete with your own cocktail waitress. Let us do the driving, you do the partying. Try your hand at our slot machine and walk away with cool prizes. Everyone's a winner. Who knows, you may end up in our picture gallery. Don't worry, what happens here stays here. The party lounge. Call and book your next party with us.
You know, I really know this feeling. I just can't trust him because he has too many lady friends. Okay, Mark, what's up with all these lady friends?
I don't know. I just get along better with girls, so only natural to have more girlfriends.
And you had this before you got married, right?
Absolutely.
It's always been going on. This is nothing new.
Absolutely. I think we're all on the same level. I had 4 older sisters, so I'm in tune with them, so I'm always getting along better with women. So
well, Mikki, I see you shaking your head. Why are you saying it wasn't always going on?
Well, he's always had women friends and whatnot, mm-hmm. but we go out to clubs a lot and whatnot, and he just goes out of his way to flirt or to meet girls, and, you know, he'll bring them over and we're introduced and whatnot, and, you know, we'll call them later and we'll all be friends later, mm-hmm. but he's still the one making the contacts.
And how does that make you feel?
I don't understand why he has to do it, that's all. Like, why do you have to go meet?
Do you feel disrespected?
Yeah, kind of. Like, what are these women thinking that this is your wife and here you are going over and talking to them or, you know?
But, Mikki, when you say, I don't know why he has to do that,
mm-hmm.
he's saying this is who he is. He grew up with 4 sisters. He gets along better with women. He was like that when you met him. He comes this way, you know? One of the critical issues in trust is the other person is not you.
Yeah, but he's there with me, so why does he have to go out and talk to other women while he's there with his wife?
Well, but see, then there's also this fantasy assumption that you should be enough for him and he shouldn't need anything else with other women, but that's not who he is.
Mark, why do you...
You met this man, and he comes liking women, and he's pretty social, and he has all these sisters.
Mark, why do you do it? First of all, do you flirt?
Yeah. I think just my whole nature, the persona I project is kind of flirtatious, so it gets me in trouble, but I really don't go out of my way to flirt with people, but that's...
But you know that it at least upsets her, if not hurts her. So what does that mean to you, that it upsets her?
Well, you know, people got to be who they have to be, and when we got married, I didn't expect her to change for me, and this is
but
the way I've always been.
You're not like him, but he's very different from you. I noticed that when we were all backstage, Mark was the one person who came right up to me. He wanted to talk. He wasn't flirting, but he was
social.
Real friendly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's who he is.
Okay, well, the last fight that we got in, we were in Hawaii.
When was the last time you had a fight?
We were in Hawaii not too long ago, and some mutual friends of ours were there, women, of course, and they were there, they were staying in another hotel, and we had been out at the beach all day, and I was just burnt out, exhausted, and they wanted to go out and club and party, and I just, you know, was over it. I didn't want to go. But he wanted to go anyway, out with two girls, while his wife stays home at the hotel, and I'm like, I don't think so, you know?
Wait, you know, I rented the big car, so I was under an obligation to show everyone a good time. And I know how to get around the island, so they were always depending on me to show them the hot spots.
They could have took a cab that
night. I'm like Julie McCoy or something. I'm the cruise director. They look towards me for this guidance and direction, and I want them to hop in the car and get it on.
Well,
a good time.
I just want to make a point here, guys. I just want to make a point for everybody and for all of us. And that is, when you enter into a relationship, and particularly a marriage, part of the task is to adjust in such a way that you hold the other person in your consciousness and have an awareness of what your behavior and how it'll impact them. And if, for example, let's assume just for the moment that you are not flirting and she thinks you are, but you have to work that out. If you just say you got to be who you got to be, then you might as well be alone. And I'm not chastising you. I mean, that's true for all of us.
Oh, ouch, well, doctor.
I'm just curious for Mikki and Katina. Each of you, what would you need in order to trust your husbands again?
I don't know. I mean, I trust him when he's, you know, flirting or whatnot. I don't think he's going to do anything to hurt me or whatnot, but just to know how I feel when he does these things, just, you know, think about what you're doing in front of me.
We're going to find out if Mars and Venus can ever trust each other again when we come back.
When the sun goes down and the lights go up, come sail with us.
Welcome to the party lounge, ladies.
It's the wildest ride on wheels.
Complete with your own cocktail waitress. Let us do the driving. You do the partying. Try your hand at our slot machine and walk away with cool prizes. Everyone's a winner. Who knows? You may end up in our picture gallery. Don't worry. What happens here stays here. The Party Lounge. Call and book your next party with us.
Today are struggling with issues of trust. Judith and Jim, any final advice for our couples on how to restore their trust?
Yeah, absolutely. You have to understand that all relationships are co-created, so you've got to do it together.
You guys need to go deeper in your expression of affection, and for Mikki, that means asking more that you be first in his life. He's always going to have lots of gals. He's got four sisters, but ask him for more and let her know she's number one.
And Mark, just please remember that everybody... And please remember that none of us behave in such a way that we don't have impact on others. Our behavior impacts others. If the other comes to you and says, that hurts me, take them seriously. Don't say something like, well, that shouldn't, or I can't understand it. Take it seriously. So if she is complaining, if Mikki is complaining, Mark, about this issue, take it seriously without having to give yourself away and open up to see what the possible resolution might be. It'll take work, but you'll get there.
Thank you so much.